pine blister rust. Oh, it's a doggone shame, but it's part of the job. Find me more if you can. Not again. That's yellow toad flax. But what it really is a pain in the keister. Seek and destroy with extreme prejudice, buckaroo.
Later, American trappers rendered the French name in English as Golden Ridge Reserve. I quite like the old moniker, but hey, the new one's not too shabby. Hot springs here are an esteemed natural resource, first utilized by the ancestors of the Shoshone further back than the books go. Mountain men exploring the area came back with tall tales of bubbling mud and steaming rivers, leading to high ridicule from their despondent comrades. It seems nature's gems were dismissed as pure delirium, but further expeditions and explorations elucidated the matter better than words ever could. The stories were real, and the beautiful, bubbling geysers were our park's very own wonder. The history of our hot springs as a hot property goes back to 1906, and one Gregoire Lacroix, a French-Canadian immigrant who staked a mining claim on the banks of this here park. What he found himself in was a spot of hot water, and much like that Archimedes fella, soon thunk of something crafty. Riverbank hot tubs were the first place his mind went, and soon folk from all over were following along. Decades later, mud ain't the only thing heating up. Turns out Mother Nature's bounty ain't half easy to make a few pennies off. But hey, what can you do? They treat me nicer than any other parasites I got, and they never forget my birthday, which is more than I can say for my tapeworm.
plan is to let these loosestrife dry up, burn them down like hell's teeth. You've still got 3/4 to go, so don't let up. I thought so. Orange hawkweed. I've had it up to here with them. And you can't see, but I've actually got my hand held real high. Go get rid of them so I can rest my arms, Buckaroo. I've seen a quarter of the plants now, but just one of them can produce 500,000 seeds. That would take more than a few buckaroos to get through. So let's chalk that down to worst case scenario.
The human history of the park itself began at least 11,000 years ago, when the ancestors of the contemporary Shoshone began to hunt and fish in the region. Obsidian, which you'll see dotted around the park, was a key part of their culture. Here you see the tracks of my tears. One more of man's attempts to siphon away nature's bounty at a heavy cost. This railway here carried a precious cargo out of the park to be refined and sold for coin. However, it got shut down when the powers that be did the right thing for once. After the mining industry was ixnayed here at the park, we had no more need for a choo-choo or two. Now they're gone to join the rest of the metal they hauled out of here.
as I live and breathe another Douglas fir beetle infestation. Comb the area and see if you can spot more. That's all the telltale signs of a bark beetle infestation. I'll notify the fire department that we got an at-risk area on our hands. Look at that, Buck. It's like some joke. This blister rust is making a meal of Mother Nature, and it's some nasty meal, like quinoa salad or something. If it's born in the ground, it should stay there safe and sound. You're a quarter closer to just desserts, Buckaroo.
Obsidian was used to make cutting tools, weapons, and especially arrowheads. Those arrowheads have been found as far as the Mississippi, which means the locals were likely trading the precious stone to other tribes.
You're making good headway on those hawkweed. This piece of work is aggressive like a mad dog and just as persistent when they get their teeth in. Quarter down, keep it running, Buckaroo.
This here is what folks call Ghost Town. Although a few hundred years ago, you'd have known it as Prosperity Spring, the mining hub of Wyoming. Lovely name, but there's nothing nice about chipping away at nature's beauty for some pretty rock. It may be hard to picture now, but the powers that be didn't always see the value in protecting a place like Golden Ridge. Instead, getting carried along in the gold rush that washed the reserve down the drain. It's hard to say how much damage the toxic metal and acid runoff did to the park. I'm relieved to say that those who could put their foot down before the elks, bears, and whatever Johnson was around got ran out of house and home. Now the town rots where it stands and the gold stays where it should. Thank you.